السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، المسلم يسعى جاهدا أن يجعل عمله خالصا لوجه الله سبحانه وتعالى في عبادته وفي كل ما يقوم به، إلا أنه قد تأتي عليه بعض الأوقات يشك هل في هذا العمل إخلاص أم أنه يشوبه شيء من الرياء أو كما يسمى الشرك الأصغر. ولذلك حذر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم منه في قوله: يا أيها الناس اتقوا هذا الشرك، يعني الشرك الأصغر، فإنه أخفى من دبيب النمل. قالوا: يا رسول الله كيف نتقيه وهو أخفى من دبيب النمل؟ قال: قولوا: اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من أن نشرك بك شيئا نعلمه، ونستغفرك لما لا نعلمه. So the Muslim always tries his best to make his actions, his worship, everything that he does, to make it sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to have ikhlas and to have sincerity in his actions and in his deeds. However, at certain times, he or she might have some kind of doubt about the deeds and the actions, whether they are done for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or there is any kind of showing off. And the showing off in the actions and the deeds is considered as shirk, which is minor shirk. And shirk means associating a partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is a minor association of partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if the action is confused or is mixed with the riya or with the showing off. For the Muslim to avoid that and to make sure that his worship and his actions are absolutely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and there is no minor shirk included in it, or there is no showing off, there is no riya, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had given instruction to his companions and to every Muslim how to avoid that. One day he talked to them and he said to them, beware, he said, O people, beware of this shirk, of this minor shirk, because it is more subtle than the footsteps of the ants. More subtle means that it is more hiding. Yani, the person himself might not know that his actions and his deeds are mixed with the riya or with the showing off or with the minor shirk. So he said, beware of this minor shirk because it is deceiving, it is more subtle, it is more hiding than the footsteps of the ants. Imagine if you see an ant, like subhanAllah, creeping, you will not hear the footsteps of this ant. So he said that this minor shirk, or this showing off, it is actually more subtle and more hiding, and you cannot even realize it, the same way that you cannot actually conceptualize and recognize the footsteps of the ants. So the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sought remedy for that. So how can we avoid it? If it is more hiding like that, and it is deceiving, and we are not sure if we have it in our actions and in our deeds or not. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had given teachings and instructions. He had given the guidelines how to avoid it. And he directed them to a very special dua, to say, when the Muslim says this supplication and this dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect him from this minor shirk and from this showing off. He taught them this dua. He said, always say, Allahumma inna na'udhu bika من أن نشرك بك شيئا نعلمه ونستغفرك لما لا نعلمه. Which means, O Allah, we seek refuge with you from associating anything with you knowingly. يعني we're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from associating any partner with him in our worship, in our ibadah, knowingly, intentionally. O Allah, we seek refuge with you from associating any partner with you knowingly. And we seek your forgiveness for that of which we are unaware. وَنَسْتَغْفِرُكَ لِمَا لَا نَعْلَمُ. So in this dua, we have two main things. The first one, we're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that if there is any kind of intentional or intended showing off or minor shirk in our ibadah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from that. We do not want to do it. We don't want to have it. طيب, we did that. Now the second part of the dua says, O Allah, if I have done anything and I am not aware of the associating of partner with you in that action, and I did any kind of action and I am not sure if there is any kind of showing off in this action or not, now I ask for your forgiveness. So if the Muslim memorizes this dua and says it all the time, he will be protected from the intentional or the intended association of partners with Allah, and will be protected also from the unintentional one. The dua again is, اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من أن نشرك بك شيئا نعلمه ونستغفرك لما لا نعلمه. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our actions and our deeds and to grant us success, sincerity in our actions and our deeds, as we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us from those who listen to the words and follow the best of them. اللهم إنا نسألك الإخلاص في القول والعمل. اللهم إنا نسألك الإخلاص في القول والعمل. اللهم إنا نسألك الإخلاص في القول والعمل. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى ومن العمل ما ترضى برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في ديننا ودنيانا وأهلينا وأموالنا. اللهم استر عوراتنا وآمن روعاتنا. اللهم احفظنا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا ومن فوقنا. ونعوذ بعظمتك اللهم أن نغتال من تحتنا. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والعصر, إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. جزاكم الله خيرا.